Hello guys, this is Afsal from Cyberzing FX. This tutorial for universal indicator EA. First I will explain what this EA is. Universal indicator EA is not like any other EA which will trade by its own trading logic. This EA takes or read signal from other MT4 indicators which is available in MT4 market or outside. So if you have an indicator which works for you and you need to automate that EA to take trades, universal indicator EA will help you in this. So you don't want to program yourself an expert advisor for your EA, or you know you don't need to hire a developer to create an EA using that indicator signals. Give the indicator name in the settings and start trading using your indicator signal. So as every EA you need to put universal indicator EA inside a expert advisor folder in MT4 terminal. I will show where it is. Open data folder, ql4, experts, and here we have universal indicator EA. So to start automated trading, switch on this switch, auto trading switch in MT4 terminal. After that, open a chart. Here we opened Euro USD H1 chart and click or drag this universal indicator. First I will explain the settings available in the EA. This expert advisor works in two modes. One is the indicator mode, like as I said, you can give the indicator name in the settings and the EA will take signals from your indicator and trade. The other option is you can place manual trade using the EA and later EA will manage your manual trades based on the given other settings like trading stop, break even, stop loss, take profit, and trading time. So first we will go to the tabs. This is here about tab. You have the indicator name, the latest version is 5.3, Cyberzing FX, and Cyberzing FX custom indicator. And the other one is common settings. This is you don't need to change anything. The ready for these are the default settings. Long and short means whether you need to take both buy and sell. And next is the EA parameters. First is order to execute. This is in by default it is use signal from your indicator for orders. So if you choose this option, the indicator will read the EA will read signal from your indicator to trade. So this is use signal from your indicator for orders. Then you need to give your indicator name. See here, this is the second settings, name of indicator to use. This is where you need to give your indicator. By default, it is iBuzzing FX zigzag arrow indicator, which is freely available with this here. So to trade with your indicator, you need to change this name and or replace this name with your indicator name. Like for an example, you have an EA with name X my indicator. Okay, so you can place X my indicator and second type indicator signal type. Indicator signal type, like there are different type of signal indicators. Like some signal indicators give arrows, some gives trend lines, some gives patterns, different signals. This EA supports arrow type signals and trend type signals. I will show two indicators for an example. Arrow type signal means it will give signals in some candles where we can take trade. So for example, here I will show you one arrow type signal indicator, iBuzzing FX zigzag an arrow. See, here you have an arrow, here you have an arrow, here you have an arrow. So it will, this type of indicators give you signals in different intervals when there is a trading opportunity. Another indicator is trend type, super trend. This is one of the super trend indicator. Here you can see instead of arrows, this is how lines. See, when there is a buy opportunity, it is giving buy trend, and when it reverses to sell, then it keeps on showing red signal, which is sell, and again it will show blue trend line, which means buy opportunities. So these are the two types of indicators. So here currently we are using iBuzzing FX zigzag arrow indicator, and that is arrow type signal. So we will keep it as it is. Another one is indicator shift or signal. Majority of the indicators give signal at shift 1. Shift means in our chart, see, this is our chart and the shift, this is the last candle produced. This candle is having shift 0. This candle, the last candle, is having shift 0, and then the previous candle is shift 1, and the next candle will be shift 2, shift 3, shift 4, shift 5, and go on. So majority of the indicators give signal at in the previously closed candle. So this candle. Some indicators give instant signals, so those indicators will be using the latest candle. If the EA is not taking any trade, keep changing, try changing the shift, and you can figure out which shift you should use for your indicator. And the next thing is indicator buy signal buffer. and we get a cell signal buffer. Here for sizing of X arrow it is 0 and 1. How you can find which buffer index your indicator is? This is also simple to how to find your indicator signal buffers. So here for zigzag arrow indicator, I will show how we can find it. This is zigzag arrow. See, for indicator there will be a colors tab. In colors tab you can see every buffers used by this indicator. See, for this indicator sizing of X arrow there is 0 and 1. See, 0, we don't know what is 0, whether it is buy or sell. So what we can do is, I will change the color this to blue and make the width 4 and set it. See, the buy arrow change, and that means buffers index 0 is buy buffer, and the another one will be the sell. Second one is 1, and we will give some red and give the height 4. Yes, see, the one is sell buffer index. So like this you can also find your indicator buy and sell buffers. Next, what we have is minimum value to check for buffers. Majority of the indicators use the currency price value in the buffer. Few of them may give minus values. So if your indicator is giving minus value, you can put that minimum value here in the settings. I will show how you can find the indicator buffer value. See, for this zigzag indicator, in terminal there is data window. And now you can go right side, there is two buffers. You can see that buffers here. So this is buy buffer, this is sell buffer. So if I hover on buy signal, the value will be populated in buy buffer, first buffer. See, and if I hover to sell, you know, the value will be there in the second buffer for 1. So this is how you can find the values in your buffer for indicator. The next setting is take profit pips and stop loss pips. That's you already know how many pips that TP DEA should place for an order, and how many stop loss pips you need to set for that order. This is other settings for stop loss. Use candle high low as stop loss. If you put this as true, DEA will scan previous candles, this 50 candles, like number of candles to find high low. So here we'll scan 50 candles and set stop loss above the highest candle if it is a sell, and below the lowest candle if it is a buy. So if you, and also here, see in brackets, stop loss pips added to this, so it will put stop loss below the lowest candle, also adding the stop loss pips. If you don't want any buffer pips for that, you can put it 0. You will know, you will place exactly just below the carry. Next one is trailing stop settings. I will detail about trailing stop settings in another video. And there is break even settings. This is also I will explain in next videos. And other is order settings, that is load size. We have a load multiplier. If you don't need a load multiplier, you can put this load multiplier as 1. So the load will not be multiplied. Close trade at opposite signals means the indicators will be having, majority of the indicators will be having buy and sell signals. So here, if you need your order to be closed, if other opposite signal appears, for example, your indicator gives buy signal and you the EA plays on buy order, and after some time indicator gives sell signal, you need to close the buy order and place sell order. So if you put this settings as true, the EA will close the previous order and open the new order. The next one is maximum number of trades. So here it is 1. If you put it as 1, EA will take only 1 trade for this pair. Next setting is trade time settings. This time is based on broker timing. If you need to close the open trade after the given time, you can put this settings as true. Other two are slippage pips and magic number. That is the maximum slippage you need to consider for taking trades, and the magic number as every year have to track down the orders. So these are the settings. I will give more details in next videos. So stay in touch and please subscribe to my channel so you can get new videos, new trading analysis, and familiarizing. I will give more details and tutorials on other indicators and other EAs that will benefit you. So stay in touch, subscribe the channel. Happy trading, stay safe, bye.